Hello and welcome to the International Area Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the top stories from across the globe. Let's take a look at today's headlines. Personal attacks mark a right-wing US presidential debate. French police dismantle camp of migrants preparing to cross the English Channel. UN report on Yemen points to a pandemic of human rights violations. Activists rebuild collective of Sahrawi human rights defenders in occupied Western Sahara. Hindu nationalist leaders acquitted in the Babri Masjid demolition case. The United States saw its first presidential debate between the nominees of the two largest parties, Donald Trump and Joe Biden, on Tuesday, September 29th. Although the TV networks and mainstream media that extensively cover the debate claim it to be a crucial event for candidates to elaborate on their policy decisions, last night's debate had very little of that. Activists and progressives have pointed to the especially right-wing tilt that the debate has taken, especially with both Biden and Trump undermining the demands of police reforms and talking down the left-wing resurgence in the US political scene. Eugene Perrier of Breakthrough News has pointed out how the debate did not address either candidate's policy plan to deal with multiple crises affecting both the US and the world right now. Trump's record of handling the raging COVID-19 pandemic was expected to take the spotlight in the debate, but the debate was dominated by personal attacks and ad hominems. There was some attempt by Trump to defend his administration's response, prompted by questions. Trump eventually turned it into a personal attack on Biden. Later in the debate, Biden in fact took the time to disown and undermine the rising left-inclined political tendencies in his Democratic Party. He strongly also opposed calls for police defunding and in fact added that the police departments need more support. The comments come at a time when the US is witnessing daily mass demonstrations against police violence and structural racism, with rising calls to either defund or dismantle the police altogether. Political theorist Jody Dean pointed out how Biden's stand only shows how indistinguishable the opposition Democrats are from the ruling Republicans. On Tuesday, French law enforcement officials dismantled a migrant camp in Calais. The camp had hundreds of migrants who were waiting to cross the English Channel and enter the United Kingdom. Over 800 people were evacuated to reception centers in different parts of France. Among them were 14 women and 8 minors who were transferred to social rehabilitation accommodation centers. Another 34 immigrants were detained and held to be subject to deportation proceedings. With around 500 tents, the camp was set up near the access highway to the port of Calais. 2 months earlier, another similar eviction took place in the dunes, which is next to an industrial area where several migrant camps have been installed in recent years. Earlier this week, around 250 activists from migrant associations from the Horn of Africa held demonstrations to protest against the prefectural ban on food distribution to them. Human rights defender Claire Heedon also denounced the degrading and inhuman living conditions of migrants in Calais. On September 10th, French authorities came out with an order preventing organizations that are not recognized by the French state from distributing food to residents in the camps. They alleged that these humanitarian actions disturbed public order and did not comply with social distancing measures. On Tuesday, the third report of the group of eminent international and regional experts on Yemen was formally presented to the Human Rights Council. The report gives details of human rights and international law violations in Yemen, including indiscriminate airstrikes, recruitment of child soldiers, unlawful killings, sexual abuse, and torture, among others. The report titled Yemen, A Pandemic of Immunity in a Tortured Land was released on September 9, 2020 and covers the period from July 2019 to June 2020. The report says that many of the human rights and international law violations in Yemen amount to war crimes. According to the report, all the parties involved in the decades-long war are responsible for the violations. The report argues that the forces loyal to the exiled government of Yemen under the leadership of Mansour Hadi and its international partners such as Saudi Arabia and the UAE have regularly indulged in war crimes. It also indicts Houthi rebel forces for similar violations. The report demands the UN Security Council to refer the situation in Yemen to the International Criminal Court and expand the list of persons sanctioned. The war in Yemen started in 2015 after the Saudi-led international coalition intervened militarily in favor of the government led by Hadi, who had been deposed by the rebels led by Houthi's militia, alleging corruption and mismanagement. The war has killed thousands of people. The Saudi-led land, sea and air blockade of the country has led to serious lack of essential commodities, including food and medicine in the country. This has pushed millions of Yemenis on the verge of starvation and death, creating the largest humanitarian crisis of the century, as per the UN. Despite the international condemnation and appeals of the UN, Saudi-led coalition with active support of the US continues its airstrikes and ground offensive against the Houthi government. On Friday, human rights activists and left intellectuals of the Western Sahara came together in the occupied territories to formally found the Collective of Sahrawi Human Rights Defenders, or CODISA. The new leadership of CODISA vowed to fight to defend the human rights of the Sahrawi people and work to realize their aspirations. The founding Congress adopted the statute and guiding principles of CODISA and released a Congress statement which recognized the status of Western Sahara as an occupied territory needing decolonization. The statement holds the Spanish colonial power responsible for protecting the human rights of the people and ending the Moroccan occupation of the territory. It notes the need to implement all relevant international humanitarian laws, including the laws related to the occupied territories in Western Sahara. It also demands greater involvement of the international community in the life of Sahrawi people who have sovereign right over the territory and its resources. The Congress statement demands the African Union to contribute to guarantee the Sahrawi people to exercise their right to self-determination through a free and fair referendum to decolonize the last African colony. It also demands the European Union to exclude Western Sahara from all its agreements signed with Morocco and stop being a party to the Moroccan exploitation of Sahrawi resources. Western Sahara, located in the African Maghreb, is a former colony of Spain. Majority of its territories have been under Moroccan occupation since 1975, the year when Spain announced the end of its colonial control. The founding Congress of CODISA, which has been in existence since 2007, was held in the memory of martyrs Hassana Talambuya El-Wali and Ibrahim Mohamed Saika. At the end of the Congress, the members of the collective elected 18 members to CODISA's executive office and 41 members to its administrative committee. Babu Zaid Mohamed Said was elected as president of CODISA's executive office, Abdul Khalik Labdil Sidi Mohammed as secretary, and Saleh Mohammed Ali Najembani as its treasurer. The Congress also elected two vice presidents for CODISA's executive office, Izana Mohammed Mubarak and Khadijatu Sidi Al Bukhari Omar. The executive office includes 11 advisors. On Wednesday, the court in India ruled that a demolition of the 16th century Babri Mosque in 1992 by Hindu rioters was not pre-planned. The verdict acquitted senior leaders of the ruling Bharatiya Janata Party for lack of evidence. Among the list of accused included 92-year-old former Deputy Prime Minister Lal Krishna Advani. 32 people were accused of criminal conspiracy and inciting a mob to tear down the Mughal-era mosque in the northern town of Ayodhya. The demolition resulted in nationwide violence that left around 2,000 people dead, most of them Muslims. The Hindu nationalist BJP leaders have maintained that the mosque's demolition was a spontaneous eruption by an angry Hindu crowd. However, the mosque was demolished after a years-long campaign in which a lot of religious frenzy was whipped up by Hindu right-wing forces. The right-wing Hindus believe that the 16th century mosque, named after Mughal Emperor Babur, was built at the place where Hindu deity Ram was born in Ayodhya. The Communist Party of India Marxists came out with a statement stating that the verdict will blemish the image of India as a secular, democratic country governed by the constitution and that the CBI must immediately appeal against this judgment. In November, the Supreme Court of India had come out with a ruling that allowed for the construction of a Hindu temple on the site of the demolished mosque. And this is all we have for this episode of the International Daily Roundup. For more such stories and videos, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Thank you for watching.